everybody. Welcome to this webinar. This is the final webinar in a series that HTA has produced this year, 9 in total. So we're going to discuss 7 HTA hacks that you must use to increase profits in sales. And for HTA certified dealers that are watching this, it's more of a review, but a great review because we all need reminders from time to time. Going to launch a quick poll here. And if everybody can participate, this would be great. This is about challenges that you have right now in your business closing sales. Everyone, no one has 100% close ratio.
And then some people out there have 100% close ratio, Josh, but their prices are too low. That's their problem.
Yeah, trunk slammers.
That's a different issue. That's a different issue.
So I want to make a statement of fact here, and that is that HTA certification does for sure give dealers major advantage in closing sales, increasing efficiency in sales, and raising overall ticket prices. But there's a disclaimer: if you use the tools, so the tools must be used. So to benefit from what we're talking about today, take some slight tweaks in your sales process. To illustrate, if you have a great set of tools in your garage, you could build all sorts of amazing things. But if you don't use the tools, then nothing happens. And you can't blame the tools for that. You have to blame yourself for not using the tools. Same thing with being HTA certified. So it does take some active work on your part, but not much. So the dealers that use these tools, don't waste time putting proposals together for clients that have unrealistic budgets. And they've made those slight tweaks to their process. We've been around now for a little over 4 years. We have over 210 dealers now that are certified, and we're basically crowdsourcing back the information that we have learned from you certified dealers. And so, and all the ones that aren't certified yet, you get to listen in and learn how these people are winning from this. Eric is coming at this from the integrator standpoint. He is an HTA certified integrator in Los Angeles, and I of course run HTA. So we both have different perspectives on this. And I want to do a shout out to the supporting brands that you see on these tiles here. These are the brands that support HTA's message of delivering excellence to consumers. And these are the companies that deserve your business. If you go to htacertified.org and you click on resource guide, you could dig into all the different categories that these brands deal with. Here we go. So it's just Eric and I on the screen. All right. So let's get into these 7 tools. The first one I'm going to talk about, the first hack, is differentiation. So this is the HTA elevator pitch. So just for those that are kind of new to HTA, you know, most of the people on here are certified integrators, but some of you aren't. So we are a consumer-facing association that created the first and only standard of excellence for integration firms. So I'm going to show you our website page because this right here is important. It shows exactly who we are. It says right here in our mission statement, we help homeowners and home design and building professionals find qualified home technology integration firms for their construction projects. So we are a consumer-facing association. Now, why is this important? Consumers don't know about our industry. They wrongfully assume that you are just as qualified as a trunk slammer. They don't know. They don't know the term trunk slammer. They wrongfully think that everyone sells probably the same stuff and probably has the same knowledge base, like they would assume hiring a plumber and electrician, but we know differently. So how does HTA work? Well, we as consumers look to standards out there, such as GIA certification for diamonds, such as the Michelin stars for the best restaurants, or an ASE certified mechanic. So in our normal lives, we look for standards of excellence. And if that company, that mechanic, that restaurant, that diamond has certification, we have a trust to it. That's what we are. We're a consumer facing association. And just like ASE and GIA aren't necessarily household names, like who even knows who puts out the 5-star safety rating for cars? It's a long acronym, NHTSA. Most people don't know that, but if they see that there's a 5-star safety rating for a car, they trust that it's a safe car. That's who we are. So You don't want to, one of the things you don't want to do in sales 101 is say you're great and everyone else stinks. You do that, people are going to tune you out right away. So how can you bring up that you're certified, and how can you educate a consumer that you are differentiated from most of the integrators out there? And by most, I didn't state this yet. Important fact, HTA's opinion on this is that 10% of the integrators out there are really good. The other 90% aren't. That's it, 10%. We built the standard to elevate those top 10%. So we came up with an elevator pitch, and I'm going to share it right here on my screen. This is a suggested elevator pitch. And of course, you could tweak it to your own liking, but this is something you'd want to say to a consumer early on in your conversation. You just say, as a consumer, you should know that there is a certification program for our industry. It's administered by the Home Technology Association. Only about 10% of the companies in this industry will meet the standards to pass this. Our company is in that top 10%. You should make sure that any company who bids on your project is HTA certified. It's hard to figure out who the good companies are. The HTA does a great job of weeding out the bad apples. Okay, just a few sentences there, but a lot of truth came across. Now you put this client on notice that there's just a few companies out there, a small percent doing a good work, and you're in that. So you didn't have to, you know, crap on your competition, so to speak, to bring that up. You're also letting your client know it's very easy to make a bad choice. And it turns the conversation, what you want to do, from competence instead of price. You've just put the client on notice that small percentage in this industry is competent. That's where we are.
What I like to say to clients is like, you know, listen, I'm HTA certified. It's really easy to make a bad choice in our industry. There's a lot of guys that aren't great out there. There's, you know, in my market, there's probably 1,500 companies that technically compete with me. And I just say, listen, if you're not going to hire me, that's fine. But, you know, you should hire an HTA certified company. Just whoever you hire, make sure that they're HTA certified so you can get a good experience, because it's very, very easy to make a bad decision in here. So I just like to reiterate that.
Let's go into our second hack, and that is the silent salesperson, as we call it, and that's HTA branding. So we discussed what this is all about, and there's a logo that backs this up. So you want to use this logo everywhere. You want to use it on your website, documentation such as proposals and design and engineering docs. Eric's going to show his. There's one of his engineering docs. It's right there that he's HTA certified, right on the documentation. Put it on your website. There you go. What's that? It's your proposal. Right on his proposal. He has that. And we even have an insert here that I'll show you. This is something that we make up as a graphic for all of our dealers. We have it in three flavors. This is I'll shrink it down a little bit, an 8.5 by 11 insert that goes into your proposals. It hits all the high points again, just reiterates why you're a top dealer. We make these graphics up for you. So there's a one page, 8.5 by 11. Depending on your proposal layout, maybe you want a half page. So we have a half page version here. It's a little more condensed. And then finally a quarter page. So we have it in three different flavors. Put this in your proposals. It's basically a silent salesperson. Also showing you that we have stickers for your vans, HTA certified. We give you the graphics. If you do a van wrap, that could be built in. And right here on a door, you know, if you have a showroom or a place you meet clients, put your HTA sticker on your door. Just like an ASC certified mechanic, when you go to a mechanic, you usually see that plaque on the back of a wall that gives that client, that gives you and me as people going to mechanic, that extra feeling of confidence that this mechanic knows what the heck they're doing. Of course, you could use it in your business cards, like my shirt, and a lot of, here, there it is. The dealers often will put it right on their sleeves. A lot of them wear it proud. So business cards, all that stuff. Be sure you get it out there. So if you're a certified dealer now and you're not putting this out front and center, you're really missing out on that.
So what a lot of people don't realize, and particularly on your digital marketing, is that a consumer will, you know, all the sort of reports show that a consumer will stalk you 7 times online before they actually pick up the phone and call you or hire you. So they're looking at you, they're doing their online research. They're never telling you they're doing it, but they're doing it. Just think about how you shop. You know, you're looking at Yelp reviews, you're looking at you know, if you buy a car, you're going to the website a dozen times. But so they're online looking at you, and you might not have a big digital presence. You know, you might not have, you might not be on a lot of sites. You might not have a lot of publications or stories about you. But what you have as an HTA dealer is you have that HTA certification link. So that should come up when somebody Google searches you. So which is a good positive affirmation if they dig into that and click through that, because they say, oh, okay, this association exists. Amazing. You know, these are good dealers. But on top of that, you want to make sure you have that HTA logo on your website. They're looking for differentiators. They're looking for reasons to hire you over somebody else, because again, consumers are super confused, right? You know, they get these proposals, it says Sonance, it says Crestron, or it says Savant, and it says Origin, you know, whatever the case may be, it all is Greek to them. It all seems like the same stuff. And these integrators that they meet or talk to all know more about technology than they do. So they're all quote unquote, you know, experts, right? So again, the buying process is very confusing for a consumer. You can't discount that. So they're going to go online, they're going to do the research. If you've got HTA plaster on your website versus a guy that doesn't, it gives you a competitive edge, super easy. And particularly super helpful if they click through and they go to the website and they find what that's about.
Thanks, Eric. And also something for our dealers to know about too, you have your about us blurb, right? Why us or about us in your story. Put the HTA narrative into that. And that goes for online listings. If on your LinkedIn company page, if you have a Facebook a page, a house page, any of those pages out there in the internet, like Eric says, clients are doing this homework. You want to keep reiterating that, because when the client keeps seeing that, that standard becomes more and more ingrained into their head. And I didn't click onto this. We're not going to do a full tour on our website today, but our standard is defined on there. There's a page on there that says HTA certification defined. So once a client sees that and they read it, the chance of them not hiring you go way down, because once a client reads it, of course they want that standard. It makes common sense, and it makes any company that doesn't have the standard very suspect. So that's well covered. Now we're going to move on to our third hack, and this is an extremely powerful one. And I preach about this so much that I'm going to shut up this time and let Eric talk about this, and I'll maybe fill in, because it's so powerful. But Eric is an integrator actually using this to a massive advantage. So Eric, talk about the budget calculator.
Okay, so for those of you who don't know, on the HTA website, there's a budget calculator. It would take a client maybe 5 minutes at the most to add the values in and figure out what kind of budget they should come up with. It asks them the size of their house, how many TVs they want, how many shades they want, if they want lighting control, all the stuff. So it asks a bunch of really simple questions for them to answer. And at the end, it spits out this fairly wide budget, right? But I will tell you that it's whatever it spits out, it's probably 2 times more than they ever imagined they'd spend on their home. Okay. That's sticker shock. All right, wait, let me have it. You've all dealt with sticker shock, right? So, you know, it's never good, particularly if you're the first guy, right? So if you're the first guy they talk to and you say, oh, to do this the way you want it is $250,000. Well, they don't like that answer. Right? Because that's not what they're expecting to spend, right? They're expecting to spend significantly lower. So now they have two options. One, they're kind of doubting you, even though you're 100% right that it's $250,000 to do what they want. They're doubting you. And so what are their options? They're going to go and get another number, right? Which is a horrible thing, right? And particularly if it's a lower qualified guy, that, you know, low balls price, that is unhelpful to you. It's unhelpful to them. So What the budget calculator does for me is, before I actually talk numbers with a client, I just send them a link. Say, hey, put your what you want in there. See what it comes out to be. And the typical result I got is, wow, that's more than I expected. Great. HTA delivered that sticker shock. Not me. I am not the bad guy. I have a third party that's verifying, like, this is what things cost. So now when they're coming to me, they're not talking about price. They're talking about features they want. They've accepted the fact, they've digested the fact that that is what things cost. Now, of course, they want to be on the lower part of that scale, but realistically, they know they're not going to be. And I would tell you 9 times out of 10, when I send somebody to the budget calculator, they come back and it's like 100 to 300,000, say, is the range. They go, well, I guess I'm going to spend 200,000. It's almost always the case, right? So now we have this anchor of 200,000 that we can start with, which is a realistic budget for this client. So it That has never worked against me. It's always helped me. The other way I use it is, you know, I have a lot of opportunities coming in, particularly, and I know all you guys do as well. And it's like, what, we have a limited amount of time. How do we spend our time, right? So the budget calculator is amazing for that client that came into you from the internet or got referred and you're not quite sure if they're your client. Send them a link to the budget calculator, have them do a budget. If they never call you back, thank God, because they're not your client. You didn't have to do 57 endless proposal revisions to find out that they're not your client. And if they are your client, now they're pre-qualified. They have some sense of what they're going to spend, and they've accepted that, right? And if you haven't gone through the budget calculator, type in one of your jobs by yourself. You're going to find discrepancies, and it's not 100% accurate to the way you propose, but you're going to be in the range, and your client is going to come out of there with a realistic budget. And it's a great tool. So one, use it to save yourself time, weed out the clients that aren't your clients, and two, deflect that sticker shock. Use that third party to verify what things cost, and it makes your conversations a lot easier. But that's my sermon on the budget calculator.
Eric, share the experience you were telling me recently about the that brought you to the shading.
So one other thing that was helpful is that we were on a project that I wasn't going to mention shades because, you know, the interior designer is somebody we work with, and I didn't really want to step on any toes. But I sent the client to the budget calculator. They saw shades in there. They immediately put it in the budget. And then, you know, when they shared with me the results, they're like, yeah, well, I didn't realize you guys did shades because I wasn't going to bring it up. Yeah, we definitely want you to do the shades. I said, well, you know, the interior designer probably wants to supply those. And his response was, no, if you're doing the control, I definitely want you to supply the shades. I'll tell the interior designer I want you guys to handle it. So I, you know, it was a great way for me not to be the bad guy. But, you know, the lesson learned is that clients will tend to upgrade themselves when they see what's possible or what systems are available. You might forget to mention security cameras or access control or something like that. The budget calculator forces the client to think about those things and ask you about them, even if you're not pitching it. So it's been pretty valuable in growing the ticket for me as well.
To share another experience from one of our integrators, this was early on in early HTA days, and he explained it to, and this is a true story, Brian Mills, Mills Technologies. He gets certified, and doing an onboarding phone call with him, and he says, I've already made tens of thousands of dollars off this calculator already. I said, well, what? How? You just got certified like yesterday. And he said, I thought it was brilliant. I sent it out to all my architects, designers, and builders. And one of the architects that uses me, I'm not the only guy he uses a few different integrators. He hands out some cards. He says, but he's the type of architect that likes to make the client introductions in person. I get to the office, he's already using the calculator right there in a meeting with the client. I'm not even driving. He's driving it, going through the questions. The clients look at me and say, so can you put the system together within this price range? And Brian says, absolutely. Clients say, what's next steps? And says, I get a design retainer. I'm going to do a full design and engineering package for you. And then, you know, we'll make another appointment and get into the nitty gritty of your home. But that's the next step. They wrote a check right there. Didn't bother even meeting the second and third integrator. It's, you know, it was a game changer for him. And the big point is, he says, I've known this architect for some time, but he thinks of me as an AV and controls integrator, not networks, not shades, not lights, all the other things I do. And he said, but because it was in that flow, just like Eric had that situation, it was in the flow of that budget calculator, he's doing the whole thing. So he said, after 5 years of telling this architect, I do all this stuff, all of a sudden the calculator just kind of made it all happen for him. So it'll bring you into more subsystems.
Even the best architects still call us AV guys. They don't call us home technology guys. It's, you know, it is what it is.
Yeah. So the other thing I want to share too is that it makes budgets go up. Eric kind of shared what it did with the shades, but another thing that happened, another story, this happened with an integrator up in Northern California who admittedly wasn't using the calculator. He told me this after about a year of being certified. So shame on him, but he learned a lesson. And that was this is a San Francisco market, very expensive market. And the client is spending real money on all these systems, except, and this is hilarious here, you're going to laugh, but he had a dedicated space in the house for a theater. And he says, I don't want to spend more than $20,000 on this room, which of course you can't do on a high-end theater, or at least in a high-end home, have anything that's resembling a real home theater for 20 grand. And he says, and this is despite the fact that he's being realistic with all his other budgets. So he's commiserating with his staff about this. And then one of the new girls, the sales ladies that started, said, well, did you send him the HTA calculator? He goes, I don't use that thing. Just blew it off. And she said, well, you got nothing to lose. He sent it to him. So he sends him an email link. Next day, the client calls up and goes, okay, bump it to 150. $20,000 one night, $150,000 the next day, because you sent him a calculator link. That there's, I'll send you a link later on to where that quote actually is. So you could, you know, name names and all this, but that's what this thing does. It has power because it's coming from an authority. HTA is an authority on the industry. We're brand agnostic. We're a neutral tool. And anything that the client reads on our site is basically dedicated to them having a great technology outcome. This is what you need to spend to do things right. It's a powerful thing. So don't underestimate what it can do, and save the 1 to 2 days of putting proposals together. Work more efficiently, right? If this client's, like Eric said, all there's revisions, your value engineering, the client doesn't know what things cost and you're trying to bring it down and down and down, save yourself that time, put the budget calculator out there up front and use your time more wisely, because right now you're turning away more business probably than because you don't have enough staff to finish it all. So pick the clients that are going to spend the money. So just so you know, you might have noticed this yourself, but if you go to crestronhome.com, they've embedded the calculator right on their website. So has CE Pro, so has Connected Design, so has Residential Systems. Some rep firms are doing it. Ozzyone has an architect-facing website that's different than the normal Ozzyone website. They've embedded it. It's becoming more and more popular. KBB Online, which is a builder and designer-focused website, is going to embed it. And you're going to start seeing it on more builder and architect designer trade association websites. That's one of the things we're working on here a lot. So it's becoming, it already is the standard, but it's going to get a wider berth. And importantly, you can embed it if you're an HTA certified integrator. So let me show you what that looks like. You can embed it. And if you are a certified integrator, HTA certified integrator now, and you don't have it embedded, you can reach out to us and we will get that, show you how to do it. So here is an integrator, the integrator home. They're out of North Carolina. This is their website. If you go under About Us, there's a whole HTA certified page. This is a One Firefly website. They built a template. So if you're a One Firefly customer, you can just turn this page on. But if not, copy this. There's the high level of what HTA is, but right here, calculate your budget. It's part, as you can see, it's our calculator within his website. And here's the other magic thing that happens. Budgets built on an embedded calculator, those budgets are saved and they get emailed to you. So you can have the data of the budgets that are created. The client could opt to email it to you manually. There's a little tech checkbox, but even if they don't, we still have those budgets filed on our server and we could supply them to you. So this is a super powerful tool. Again, can be embedded in your site. So don't ever ask, what's your budget again? It's a question that it's hard for your client to answer. It's usually an uncomfortable conversation. Let this bring up the budget for you in a more natural way. Okay, we spent the most
time. And you're never gonna like their answer when they tell you what it is. Have you ever liked their answer when they told you what their budget was? No one's ever said, I got $1 million, let's spend it. No, never happens.
Yeah, let this be your friend. Okay, let's move on to our fourth point, our fourth hack. And this is drawing the line. We call it drawing the line. This is ammunition for your existing trade partners to dig in and defend you against low ballers. Eric, you got a couple points you wanted to share on this.
Yeah. So this is a great tool that I share with my builders, architects, interior designers, because they're always getting pressure, right? There's so many people, so many stakeholders involved in a job. So on a typical job, you got an interior designer, you got a builder, you got an architect. In LA, we got a lot of construction managers. We got the client. Everyone has an integrator in their corner. And whoever's the strongest voice usually gets to pick who the actual integrator is. Could be the client, could be the builder. But in the situations where, say, for instance, a builder really wants to use me and wants to dismiss all of the other bidders in the project, HTA certification gives them a tool, because they can say now to their interior designer, whose cousin has an AV company, like, no, sorry, can't use your cousin, would love to. I only use HTA certified firms, right? Then they've got a valid sort of standard of excellence that they operate on, it's not objective, or it's not subjective, I should say. So it's a great tool for that builder that loves you, that architect that loves you, that wants to use you and wants to rule out some of these guys that are maybe not the greatest integrators in the world. It's a very, very effective tool. So don't not use that with the guys that really want to use you.
We'll tag team with you as a dealer to get the word out about HTA to your industry partners as well. So for example, I'm going to share, this is for those that are HTA dealers, this is part of your digital assets, but this is marketing outreach that we'll do. So this is an optional thing. When you get certified, we'll ask for your architect, designer, and builder names and emails. And what we're going to do is send them this. So we share exactly what the subject line of the email is, what the messaging is, and I'm not going to read through this thing, but I could tell you the goal of this is to do a little bragging about you. Hey, you're certified. So we're putting you on the map with them. It's a free marketing touch of nothing else. We let them know the value of certification, what it is, why that's noteworthy for you to reach this achievement, and why it should be the minimum bid standard for them. So we'll give them that messaging. And we'll also explain, there's an article we link them to, which is designed to get them to hire you earlier in the process. Because can you ever be brought to a project too early? The answer is no. So let us help get that message out for you. We don't, and just so you know, we don't take those names and do anything with it except send this email once. We don't sign them up to any newsletters or anything spammy like that. These are your contacts. We just want to help you establish your professionalism with them. And so we can do this on our side, but what we recommend that you do, like Eric said, bring it out to all your architects, designers, and builders. And here's what could happen from it. Every single architect, designer, builder that we've spoken to or integrator spoken to have all said, hey, this is a great idea. This was needed a couple decades ago, because they've all had bad experiences with integrators. So one of the success stories down here in Los Angeles, and this wasn't from Eric, this is another HTA dealer. He was successful in getting the architect to stamp right on the bid set, are on the plan set that went out to bid, must be HTA certified to bid. Brilliant. And then when that went to the builder upheld that, because the builder understood, yeah, this is a great way to keep all these crappy integrators that are knocking on my trailer door all the time excluded from the job. Yeah, that's exactly what we're doing here. And you know how hard it is to build a good relationship with these partners. Once you've established yourself with them, they want you to win the job. So give them all the ammunition you can. That integrator didn't call and brag about it. I found out about this because we started getting all these applications in Los Angeles. So these really, you know, I live here. I've lived here my whole life. So I'm like, I never heard of these integrators before. Call around a few friends. Have you heard of these guys? Nope. And they were basically some trunk slammer companies trying to fake their way into certification. That's our job, to filter those companies out, those companies that, and I asked them, I called them out on their application because it's obviously fibbed. A lot of the numbers were obviously bogus. And then I found out when the guy said, oh, I need to be HTA certified estate tier by Wednesday. And it's a Monday. I'm like, no, sorry, it takes weeks to get certified. We have some background checks we got to do. But why? Oh, there's a big project in town. I can't bid unless I'm certified. So that's what that little wave of applications came in. So we did our job. Those companies did not make the cut. And I felt good about that in a sense, because we know that this project was a big project. It takes a certain caliber of dealer to do a project like that. Trunk Slammer is not going to be able to pull this off. So brilliant. That could happen. So I think I got all the main points I want to talk to about that. I'm going to switch into hack number five. And this, I'm calling this one credibility and earned respect. What I'm getting at is creating new relationships with industry partners. So I'm going to give you a little background on my career. I worked with Eric at DSI from 1998 until end of 2014. So I worked with Eric 16 years in sales and marketing and business development at DSI. I was the guy doing the lunch and learns. I used to teach on behalf of Cedia back when they used to educate architects, designers, and builders in the mid-2000s. So I had a lot of experience out there marketing to architects, designers, and builders. So great. I built a lot of great relationships, but something really big happened. I spent an 18-month stint as a consultant working with a company called Axiom Design. So now I'm doing design and engineering with the company that it's not an integrator. They don't sell the product. They don't install it, but they do all the front-end design and engineering. And when I went back to the same architects, designers, and builders with a consultant hat on and not my integrator hat on, all of a sudden I started getting respect. And it was like the gloves came off. We're like, I hate integrators. Integrators are always screwing up the jobs. And they don't get, it's like the wild, I kept hearing the term, it's the Wild West out there. And I'm glad you're doing this consulting thing because this makes sense. This industry needs that. And I'm like, whoa, hold on a minute. I didn't know our industry had that bad of a reputation. And why didn't this ever come out before? But I learned a lot from this. I didn't know in my older naive days that 90% of this industry is not that good. I thought maybe 50% of it wasn't that good. Well, it's a lot more than that. It's about 90%. No wonder they were so turned off by integrators. And at least in certain markets, they're pretty aggressive. The trunk slammers that aren't busy are out there knocking on their doors and marketing what they do. The good companies like you guys are so busy out there, you're not marketing as much as you should. So with that as a base, here's how you could use HTA to open new doors. So first of all, we highly recommend here, build personal relationships with your local architects, designers, and builders. Yes, it takes time, but wow, does it pay off? It's the gift that keeps giving. So how do you differentiate yourself from those companies out there that have kind of wet the bed for you, right? Because there's so many companies that have messed, that have given them bad experiences. You want to differentiate yourself because you're kind of guilty until proven innocent. Have you ever got that feeling? You meet a new architect, designer, builder, and you're like, oh, AV guy. And you're instantly a bad guy and they don't know you from anybody. It's like you're unfairly judged. So here's how if I was back in my old days as sales, marketing, business development, here's how I would approach trade partners is when you meet them and you tell them what you do, they say, so let me ask you, what's your experience been with our industry? Let me guess. It's confusing. It's really expensive. The company wasn't that professional. The client couldn't make the stuff work, right? It was real confusing and probably messed up the build cycle. And the client probably had some customer service issues after. Am I right on any of those things? They're probably going to say, yeah, okay, this person understands reality. You can basically empathize with them and say, yeah, I know that's happened. The reason I know that happens, about 90% of our industry is not qualified. They're not really, shouldn't be working on luxury construction and projects. I want to let you know, kind of goes back to the elevator pitch. I want to let you know there is a standard out there. It's called HTA certification. I just want to let you know that my firm is an HTA certified firm. I'll send you a link what that's about, but I just want to show you that we don't just say we're different. We meet this really high standard. Give us a shot. We do design and engineering documentation. We're truly a cut above. It gives you a defensible backstop of professionalism that you can back up by sending them to that link that you are a cut above. That will definitely shortcut your path to credibility with those dealers. And as soon as you make that new contact, reach out to us right away and say, hey, remember that email you sent to all my architects, designers, and builders back when I was certified? Can you send it to this new interior designer I just met today? I just met them, or we were being considered for a project, but they don't know us from anybody. They've had some bad experience with integrators. Please send that. We'd be happy to. So it's a great way to build some some excellent respect with these trade partners. And just as another sales tip, by the way, and I this is learning from me as an educator out there, I learned something from an architect that I never forgot. And this was a big wig architect in LA, Architectural Digest 100. And this is this. After doing three lunch and learns there, he took me aside and said, there's one problem we have with what your education is. You talk like you're a designer, but we think of you as a contractor. That's a hard mindset for us to wrap around. And that was a light bulb moment for me. So here's my advice to all of you. When you market your services to architects, designers, and builders, basically explain that you have three phases to your company. This will help you dramatically. You have a design consultant side, you have a contracting side, which they think of you, right? Putting stuff in the house. And then you have a aftercare service side of your business that you're basically married to that client for the life of that home. If you market yourself as those three phases, it's going to radically change the way they think about you. So trust me on that one. It's going to change the way, it's going to help with professionalism. And they understand that you can be brought in as a design consultant early. Topic number six, Eric's going to take the lead. And this is what we're calling education. Let HTA do the selling for you. So Eric.
Okay. So what I had told Josh is like, I'm constantly getting questioned on systems that I'm trying to put in. I'm trying to give my clients good quality stuff that they need. And they're pushing back for whatever reason. They're pushing back because they've got a little knowledge. They're pushing back because they've got a cousin that's smart with technology and has said, buy this, buy that. And I'm sure you've run into this. You've got the client who wants to use Ring security cameras, or you've got the client that wants to use an Eero network, you know, in a 20,000 square foot house, these type of things. You've got the client that says, oh, you don't need wires in my house. Everything's wireless nowadays. So you need, you know, you're trying to sell a big pre-wire and the client's pushing back. So I said, Josh, what I need as a dealer is, you know, a third party article that backs me up that says, hey, this is how things are done. This is the right way to do it. And so Josh did a great job of going out to a bunch of industry experts and getting articles to combat all of those objections. So I've got an, you know, an article I can send that's on the HTA website about why you should buy better security cameras, why you should buy a real enterprise grade network, why you should wire your house properly, or why you need to, why you should consider a high performance home theater as opposed to an entry level, you know, no, a sound bar is not a home theater. This is what a home theater is. So for almost every objection you get in sales about systems, Josh has found somebody to write a great article to support your argument that, you know, it's worth it to spend a little bit more money and do it right. I don't know, Josh, if you want to share where those are, but they're terrific. So basically, I send a lot of links out and my builders like them too, because my builders want my clients to install the right stuff too. So I send them links so they can send them to the client. But it's another way HTA is a, you know, a unbiased third party affirmation of, you know, what you're trying to tell those clients. It's a great backup for when you're trying to get your clients into the right equipment. So use it. That's all I got on that, Josh.
Yeah, so I'm showing, so this is just on our website under the articles link, and there's articles submitted by some companies here, some of our sponsors, and then the articles here Eric's referring to are in the main articles section. So I'm just going to scroll down. It's kind of an infinite scroll. You know, I'm just going to go down the list here. Here's an article for interior designers. Any of your interior designers, you want to send them this article. It's telling them how to work with you better. Here's the one Eric was referring to, why an enterprise grade network is a must in every luxury home. This surveillance camera article is our number one article for whatever the heck reason. It gets a ton of traffic. This is a nice one, budget advice, four vital tips. We got the budget calculator, and this kind of goes hand in hand with it. It gives clients another way to look at budget on their technology systems. If you get pushback on pre-wiring, this is the one you want to use. And scrolling on down and down, down. This is an article down here that helps if you're doing design and engineering documentation, which I hope you all are. and you should be charging for this, then this is the article here that backs up why they need it and why they should expect to be charged money for that. So great article, read this. And this article right here, this is a big one. I'm on the NAHB's Technology Council, National Association of Home Builders. And after working with custom builders for a while and learning how they're going about technology completely wrong, I made a really bold statement on a phone call with them last year. And I said, hey, you guys are having a lot of trouble with technology, and here's what you need to do. Before you get a framing, electrical, or HVAC quote, you need to get a full technology design. Only then can you get accurate bids from those three other trades. On that phone call, it would just pin drop. It's like, what are you talking about? So said, I'll write an article to back it up. So wrote this article, reproduce it here on our site, but this was published on the NAHB's website. And it basically is written for builders to tell them to do that. And it backs up the reasons why, gives them the why they need to hire you before framing, electrical, and HVAC. This is powerful. If NAHB saw fit to publish this, you have to be an NAHB member to see this because it's behind a paywall, but we reproduced it. I wrote the article, so hey, it's here too. But send this to all your builders right away. It's a game changer. It's literally a game changer when they understand that you have this whole design side of your business and that they can't get accurate bids from other trades unless they know where all the technology is going to be. So this is powerful tools that you don't want to skip. And so I think we hit everything on that. Let's see if I missed any points. Oh, one big one. The articles that you see here, we encourage our certified dealers to repurpose them. So you could basically lift them and use them on your site. All we ask for is give a credit at the end, say this article was supplied by the Home Technology Association, and create a link back to our site as credit, but you can take it. Please do. Our articles are designed to help clients make the right decisions. And if we can help you with content, that's awesome. This final hack, we call this one connections. It's who you know. So some of your prospective clients are going to ask for references. They often do. Put me personally down as a reference point. And I have a lot of good things to say about our certified integrators. Why? It's not that I'm making it up. Well, I could tell about the standard with a lot of passion. As you probably tell, I'm really into this. And from the background research we do on our dealers, we have talked to architects, designers, and builders. We've talked to industry reps, sometimes even other integrators in the market to find out about our dealers. So we have all these phrases. We know who said what. We even have scores from them. And we're going to share back some of those positive things that we have learned from others. And so it's basically an extremely solid, positive reference to hire you. So all the background work we have done on you, let that come back to help you close sales. So a few integrators have taken us up on that. And everyone that I've checked up with, they've got that project so far. So it helps. Don't underestimate the power of a really strong testimonial. So now we went over a lot right here, right? So I want to share a couple of resources because then this might be a lot to take in, but this is being recorded. We will share the recording with you. And I want to share with you a checklist because if you've been taking lots of notes like, oh, got to do this, got to do that, all of our certified dealers have this checklist, and you should already know this or have seen it many times because it's linked to in the monthly HTA dealer email. So it's just a checklist. Everything we've talked about and more, there's a lot more tools that we're not going to get into today, like social media and things, it's on here. So this is the reminder to implement these things into your workflow. So as a review, here's the 7 points on screen. The 7 HTA hacks. So you want to differentiate your company by using the HTA elevator pitch. Why? Clients wrongfully assume that you're all the same. and it changes the conversation from price to competence. You're not going to win the price battle, but you'll win the competence battle.
Add that 20 seconds to your sales pitch. It'll make a difference. It's a great tipping point.
Yeah. Second one, use branding to be your silent salesperson. Just keep reminding them you're certified. And like Eric talked about, point number three, deflect sticker shock by using the budget calculator. Cannot overestimate this enough. It's so powerful. Just have the guts to use it. Work more efficiently. Fourth hack, tell all your builders, architects, designers you're certified. Give them the ammunition they need to defend you. The fifth hack, use your status for credibility. You know, get some respect out there when you're building those architect, designer, builder relationships. So many bad integrators have hurt our industry. Show them you're different. Here's the proof that you're different. And as Eric talked about on hack number six, use our HTA website resources, the articles, and there's going to be more and more articles coming out that are designed to back up the systems that you are already selling. And then use me as a reference. So I referred to earlier that some success stories, they're all here. So if you take a snapshot of anything or just want to review the video later, if you go to htacertified.org/quotes, it'll take you to a page of some dealer testimonials. And we didn't hit on all the benefits today of being certified. The others are on our FAQ page, which just go to our website and see that. There's my contact information as well. So if you want to reach out to me personally, please do. I'd be happy to. So
I missed your use you as a reference, Josh, but I will tell you guys that Josh is a great sales guy and he will sell the crap out of your company. If you get him on the phone with a client, a builder, you know, he really believes in all the companies that have passed the certification. And if he believes in something, he's a relentless sales guy and a closer. So, you know, if you need a tipping point in a project, lean on him. It's very, very effective.
Yeah, thanks, Eric. So I'm going to go through the Q&A list here. And some of our dealers here saying some nice things. Thank you. But here's some questions. So I don't know who this is. It says anonymous. Since DTools is a partner, can we get them to work with us or create a custom reporter? Do they have one to incorporate? I'm not exactly sure what you mean there, but you saw my email earlier. It's jc@htacertified.org. So whoever you are, please email me with more specifics. We'll get into that.
Josh, I think what they're saying is, can we build HTA, a blurb into the proposal reports? DTools has all different reports with elements reports. Can we make that an element of the report? We should talk to Randy Stearns about making that happen.
And I'm going to go out on a limb and say that 99% chance, yes, DTools is a supporting brand and a big fan of HTA. They already have our graphics, our logos. So if you use DTools for plans, they'll get that built into that. So whoever you are, yeah, reach out and we could get them to get what you want on that. I'm sure they're a great partner. Where do we download those graphics? This is another anonymous attendee. So I'm assuming you mean by that the proposal inserts, and you could again email me jc@htacertified.org. And if that's what you're asking for, we'll get that to you. If that's not what you're looking for, we'll get it. We'll find out what you're talking about.
Just in general, Josh, where do they go to get kind of resources of logos and all of that stuff?
If you're a certified integrator, you have your, if you go back to your onboarding email when you got certified, there's a link on there that has links to all the assets. I'm not going to share those now because those are private. I don't want to bring those up on the screen for HTA certified dealers. But if you're missing that URL, email us. We'll get you the URL. You click on it, it's a Dropbox link, and all the asset folders pop up underneath there. So, and then we'll do the custom graphics for you though, because we drop your logo in and everything for the proposal insert. So that's something we could create for you one-on-one. Another question here was about specific wording. It says, we have an area on our website for memberships and also for credentials. Would you consider this a membership or a credential? I consider this a credential, right? You're a certified company. Think back to the ASC certified mechanic type thing. It's a credential. That's what I would consider it. And Thomas McKenzie from Cloud9. He says he's trained his builders to use the budget calculator. It's so much better getting your costs built into the builder's budgets. Thanks, Thomas. So great. You're following.
Well, I'll chime in there. I've given the budget calculator link to a lot of estimators, and I have saved a lot of wasted time. They use it on these things they're bidding on and just need a budget to plug in. It's fantastic for that too.
Yeah. Another really good question from an anonymous person here. Is the budget calculator being updated on any type of regular basis? Yes, we're always looking at tweaking it.
Josh, I think that's a really good point because pretty much all of our manufacturers have raised prices by 10% and some by even more. So all of our major manufacturers have increased costs by 10%, and that probably should be reflected in the budget calculator. I know it's wide, but the minimum cost of entry is getting higher for sure.
Yeah, we'll have to work on that. Thanks for that. Okay. Well, someone is asking about clarification on the emails to architects, designers, and builders. So here's the clarification on that. We will send that email to all the architects, designers, and builders that you have that know who you are, that have a relationship with you already. And it could be a relationship that's even maybe a little stagnant. Maybe it's a project you did with them a couple of years ago, but they know who you are. It's not for the wish list. Like there's, you know, here's a bunch of architects, designers, and builders that I want to work with, but they have no idea of who I am. No, we're not going to send that to them because like, who are you and who's the HTA? If they don't know who you are as the integrator, they're going to instantly stick it in a spam folder. And since we're sending these one-on-one on your behalf from our domain, we can't afford being stuck on a spam folder. So, but again, as you build these new relationships in your marketing and business development, we'll send that one by one by one as you build new relationships. Another question, I talked about marketing your company in three phases. So what those are again, you got your consulting slash design side of your business. So that's phase one. Hire me as a consultant designer. That is a phase. I charge you. Here's our deliverables, our design and engineering docs with all the technology placed in the home. Step two is what they already think of you as. That's your contracting phase. And the third phase of your business is your ongoing service phase. More and more integrators are having RMR. They're doing aftercare service. Maybe it's One Vision. Maybe it's Parasol or your own program in-house. Bring that up. That's a service phase. And it's good for them to know that your relationship is different than other tradespeople. The plumber, electrician, they do their job, they're out of there. You're not. You're going to be with that home for years because technology is going to need to be refreshed. It's going to need occasional service. They need to know that. And when you're bringing up that you have a service division, if you do, if you don't, get on it. If you have a service division, then they're going to respect that service is something you care about. There's a question about can we post these articles on LinkedIn pages? Yeah, that's fine. Again, as long as they have credit back to HTA as the source of that and a link, that's absolutely fine. And the budget calculator, another question, does it have health and wellness line items? Not yet. That is something that we will do as more integrators bring that into their portfolio of services. It's a bit premature in our mind right now to bring that up because not enough integrators are doing it. Are there any general requirements to go down the HTA certification path? Yes. If you go to htacertified.org and you click on Get Certified, there's a couple links on the homepage that say Get Certified. All of our requirements are there. And I think there's on our articles, can you do them with embedded metadata keywords to be used in website blogs, which help with Google searches and search placement? I think that's an SEO question there. Our articles are written with SEO in mind. You know, so when we put the article on our site, yes, we want these articles to be found. So if that's what you're getting to, we build them that way. But it does take some SEO knowledge, which we have here. I think that's all the questions that we got to. So
let me chime in if you were thinking of putting the article on your website, to me that gives you less credibility because they're not going to know it's written by an outside party. I think, you know, to me the beauty of the budget calculator in these articles is it's on the Home Technology Association website, not on my website. I kind of like it that way. Josh may disagree with me there. but I like sending someone to the HTA website because that is credibility right there, as opposed to having it on my website where they think I might doctor it, or, you know, it's questionable if it's on my website. It's 100% legit if it's on the HTA website. That's my point.
Yeah, it's kind of go along with Eric's point. That comes into, is it better to embed the calculator in the HTA calculator in your own site, or do I just send them a link to your site? And there's no right or wrong answer. I think Eric falls into the camp. I just want people to go to the HTA site. Remember I talked about you getting the data out of the calculator. For our certified dealers, as you all know, you each have a unique HTA code ID that identifies you. If you link to our calculator from your site with that little, your number in the code, it still knows it's you and you'll still get that data. So the magic still happens, even if you send them to our site. So thank you for your time. Thanks, Eric. And
no problem. Go use those hacks, guys. Taking care of-